Should you be allowed to speak in your mother tongue during English class? Nobody should be permitted to speak in their native language in an English class. Students can learn English faster and more attentively if they only hear the language they are attempting to learn. Furthermore, speaking your native language in the presence of others who do not comprehend you is considered unprofessional and disrespectful in North America. Should minors be allowed to purchase lottery tickets? Certainly not. Purchasing lottery tickets is a form of gambling, and gambling can be extremely addictive. Young people should attend school and get an education. They should prioritize a career so that they can have a good future and contribute positively to society. In your opinion, when should young people be allowed to operate a vehicle? Driving a car is both a privilege and a huge responsibility. In my native country, young people as young as 17 can take a driver's test. In Canada, they can begin driving at the age of 16. As a parent of two teenagers, I strongly believe that the Canadian government should prohibit minors from driving until they reach the age of 18. People over the age of 18 are generally more mature, responsible, and focused on the road. As a result, everyone will be safer on the road because there will be fewer accidents. When should young people be allowed to smoke or buy cigarettes? There are numerous smoking regulations. In most places, people are not permitted to smoke. They are not permitted to smoke in schools, workplaces, parks, sport fields or facilities, skate parks, movie theaters, restaurants, coffee shops, or shopping malls. They are also not permitted to smoke in a vehicle if there is a child under the age of 16. Why? Because smoking is linked to lung cancer and other respiratory issues. More seriously, smoking is lethal. Young people or anyone, regardless of age, should never be allowed to smoke or purchase cigarettes, in my opinion. When should young people be allowed to consume alcoholic beverages? Young people, in my opinion, should be permitted to consume alcoholic beverages only when they reach the age of 21. People are generally more mature and responsible at the age of 21. They will drink in moderation and will not drive under the influence of alcohol. When drivers are sober, there are fewer accidents on the road, and other drivers can drive more safely to their destinations. In your opinion, at what age should couples get married? The best age to marry with the lowest chance of divorce is between the ages of 28 and 32. People of this age are neither too young nor too old. Getting married when you are too young may lead to divorce. Waiting too long, on the other hand, could be equally problematic. Many people should have completed their undergraduate or higher education by the age of 28. They are typically more mature, responsible, and self-sufficient, with the ability to earn their own money to support themselves. Furthermore, at this age, 28 to 32, people understand the distinction between puppy love and true love. In your opinion, should couples live together before marriage? Living together prior to marriage is an option. Some people oppose it, while others believe it is a good idea. Living together before marriage allows you to learn more about each other, strengthen your joint problem-solving ability, and reinforce your relationship and ability to navigate stressors. all of which can instill more confidence in your decision to marry. Despite this, I personally oppose the idea of living together before marriage. Why? It is incompatible with my family values. In your opinion, should Canada legalize euthanasia or assisted dying? Without a doubt, death is a personal matter, and the law should not infringe on a person's right to die. It makes no sense to keep people alive if there is no cure for their disease. This will only make their suffering worse. Euthanasia allows a person to die with dignity and control over their circumstances. Allowing a terminally ill person to die is the only humane, rational, and compassionate option. That is my sincere opinion. Should you be allowed to use your bilingual dictionary or Google Translate during English class? Second language learners, in my opinion, should be allowed to use bilingual dictionaries in English class. It can be very stressful and intimidating to not understand a specific word or phrase. Anyone who uses Google Translate, however, should be aware that it does not always provide accurate translations. In fact, some translations may end up being amusing. Using a bilingual dictionary can help students understand the word they are trying to learn, but if one relies on a translation tool all the time, he is forcing his brain to rely on translations, and the brain will not function independently without it. Should young adults pay their parents' rent if they are working and do not move out by the age of 21? I'm sure some will disagree, but I believe it is only fair that young adults pay rent to their parents if they are working, earning their own money, and still living with their parents at the age of 21. They are expected to be self-sufficient at that age. They should get their own place and move out. Should the incarcerated be allowed to participate in federal, provincial, and municipal elections? When it comes to this situation, I am a firm believer that any law-abiding citizen should be able to vote. Anyone who breaks the law, on the other hand, should face the consequences of their actions. They should serve their sentences in prison and only be allowed to vote in elections after they have served their time. Should parenting classes be mandatory for all parents? All parents should be required to attend parenting classes in order to better raise their children to be productive and responsible citizens of the future. Unfortunately, many parents nowadays lack the necessary skills to properly raise their children. Some of these parents come from broken homes, while others have little formal education. If they do receive formal education, it could be because they are too preoccupied with work and other personal circumstances to spend quality time with their children. Many children are cared for by nannies or relatives. As a result, they grow up looking for love in all the wrong places or from other people. How do we address the issue of poor parenting? One way to address this issue is for the government to provide proper parenting training to these parents. Furthermore, the government should subsidize their childcare costs so that parents do not have to work long hours outside of their homes and can spend more time with their children and raise them better.